Good morning to all. We will continue with the chapter The Climate of India. Just we can memorize the last day's topic. That is, we were discussing about the four seasons in India. Based on the different months we were studied. They are the hot or dry season, starting with the month of March to May, first one that we have been studied completely. Later we were discussing about the rainy season in India. Rainy season also known as southwest monsoon wind or southwest monsoon season. And the third season in India is the season of retreating southwest monsoon wind, which is starting in the month of October and ending in the month of November. And the last and fourth season, it is the cold season or the season of the northeast monsoon wind, which is starting in the month of December and ending in February. December, January, February. These are the four seasons in India. And the first season, hot or the summer season, we studied that different characteristics of hot and summer season: intense heating, the pressure conditions and wind direction we studied, and the different local wind which is causing during this month also we have studied. Local winds like Norwester or Kali Vaishaki in West Bengal and Assam, Lu in our place like North Indian plains, especially Punjab, Haryana and UP area, which is influencing. Yesterday also there was the thunderstorm and lightning with the light raining. It is because of the local wind which is the part of the hot dry season in India. This is the month of April, that is why it is occurs in our country. And lastly, mango shabels, one another local wind which is prevails in India, in southern part of our country, that is also the part of our syllabus. We studied already different seasons. Now today we will move to the next season, that is called the rainy season or the southwest monsoon wind season. Already we studied its a few characteristics. We will move to the further discussion today. So the southwest monsoon season, also known as we have been studied the rainy season in India, and last day we studied that the seasonal reversal of the southwest monsoon wind based on the season. Sixth month it is seasonal reversal, it is taking place. That is, monsoon or periodic wind or the seasonal wind. Periodic, we studied that the main wind system in the earth surface. Monsoon are the periodic or the seasonal wind in which there is a complete reversal of wind direction every 6 months. That is why it is called a seasonal reversal of wind. You can write in the exam also, write any of the characteristics of southwest monsoon wind, there you can write the seasonal reversal of wind. You can take the notes also, short notes you can take here, for as point wise it is explaining here, that is why you can take the notes also. So seasonal reversal, northern hemisphere during these months, March, April, May, June, July, these months, almost 5 to 6 months, there is summer season existing. That is why northern hemisphere there is the arrival of the monsoon season, it is existing. We have studied last period regarding the pressure changes, what is happening in land and water. So second characteristic feature is the land breeze and sea breeze on a large scale. It is the wind which is causing basically the southwest monsoon wind is a land breeze and sea breeze. It is occurs in a large scale. You know what is sea breeze and land breeze? When the wind moves from land to the sea, it is called a land breeze. And when the wind moves from sea to the land, it is called a sea breeze. It is taking place normally when the pressure changing. If the land occupies the high pressure, then the land breeze take place. When the sea occupies high pressure, then sea breeze take place. Means that land to the sea, the wind it is moving. That is why it is called a pressure condition during this time. As you can see here, it is written pressure condition, low pressure in the land and high pressure in the sea. Whenever it is taking place, then the southwest monsoon take place. Once again I can explain, that is whenever low pressure is there in the land, that is because of the low pressure or the low temperature, sorry, high temperature, it is taking place in the land due to the intense heat during this month which is existing in our country. That is why. And at the same time, due to the low temperature in the water bodies, in water bodies or in the sea, there will be high pressure. So wind moves from high pressure to low pressure. That means from sea to the land. Its direction is from southwestern part of India towards the northeastern part of India. That is why it is called a, based on its direction, this movement of wind in a particular period of time, it is called a southwest monsoon wind or it is a seasonal wind. In the month of June it is starting and till September it is getting in a different magnitude level in India. And it is also known as land breeze and sea breeze. Why it is occurs with both, it is causing due to the differential heat of the land and the sea. Differential heat and the land and the sea. Further we will move each one, each of its particular features we will see how it is take place. We can see here the given map, we can see how the advancement of the monsoon season in India, how it is progress in our country. First of all, we can see that from the Indian Ocean moving towards the Malabar coast, it is in the western part of our, southwestern part of our country, as we can see in this map. June 1st, itself, our Kerala coast, or it is called Malabar coast. Malabar coast, this region, Malabar coast, it is reaching. Touching in Malabar coast, there you know there is Western Ghat is there. Presence of Western Ghat is there. That is why it is the wind is not moving towards this area, that is towards the way of Bengal side or the eastern side of the country. It is not going. Other than that, the Western Ghat deflect the wind towards north of India. Later it will be moving towards the northeastern part in Himalaya. Okay, that we will come. But here the presence and existence of Western Ghat, that is deflecting southwest monsoon wind towards northern India. I told you June 1st day itself it is touching into Malabar coast. Then by June 5th they overrun whole of Kerala, not only in Kerala, June 5th only, not only in Kerala, west of Tamil Nadu region, that means the adjacent areas of Kerala, then Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, proceeding towards northeast. Remember, here only within 3 days itself, moving towards almost all the South Indian states, June 5th itself. Again, June 10th, it is reaching to Mumbai in Maharashtra. Southwest monsoon within 10 days, that is June 10th, it is reaching to Maharashtra and Mumbai. After that, 15th of June, southwest monsoon reaching Ahmedabad and Bhopal, that means in Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. Which days? By 15th. So we studied that if June 1st it is reaching in Kerala, touching in India, then within 15 days almost half of the India, central part of India, including Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh, it is reaching. That means rain it is getting within 15 days. This much area, this much part of India. Then 1 month after, July 1st, June 1st it is touched in Indian coast. After 1 month, 1st July, they cover most of Kutch region, run of Kutch region. You can see in map also. And the eastern part of Rajasthan, not in western part of this area, eastern part of Rajasthan, and whole of UP and Haryana, our state and Haryana, within 1 month, that is the 1st July it is reaching. Haryana, which is the date? 1st July. And later, by 15th July, that means after reaching southwest monsoon in India, touching southwest monsoon in India, after 1.5 month, whole part of our country, it is touching. And July 1st after, it is not crossing towards northeast or north India. It is not moving towards the other countries of Asia. Why? It is because of the presence of Himalayan mountain, the great Himalayan mountain ranges. It is preventing in the northeast. That is why it prevails. The southwest monsoon prevails all over the country, especially in northern plains of our country, and getting rainfall in India throughout our country. It's a magnitude of the rainfall, it varies, of course. Then also, in a regular basis, June 1st itself, the wind which is moving towards India from Indian Ocean, then it is getting rainfall throughout the India. As it's a direction, it is from southwestern part of India towards the northeastern part of the country. That is why it is called a southwest monsoon wind. We have to remember that we have to mark its direction also. Southwest to northeastern side. You know the northeastern states also. And we will study that different mountains, how it is influencing these movements of the wind or the deflection of the wind. Already we discussed the Western Ghats. Other mountains, how it will influence, that we will see. Before that, we are moving to the next topic related with the same only, that is the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal Sea branch of southwest monsoon wind. You can take down the notes also, the advancement of the monsoon in India. You have to remember this in sequence wise itself, that already written here. Please take down the notes. 1st June in Malabar coast, it is written here. 5th June, Kerala, whole Kerala, west of Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. And 10th June, it is moving to Mumbai, that is in Maharashtra. And 15th June, it is moving towards Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. Ahmedabad and Bhopal, it is given in your book. That means in Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh it is. And in 1st July, it is reaching whole country, almost mainly it is Haryana, UP and other part of our country it is reaching. Now moving to the two division of southwest monsoon wind. It is this division of southwest monsoon wind, it is based on the divides, it is two branches due to the tapering topography of peninsular India. Topography of peninsular India. Southern part of our country, it is tapering towards the water bodies. The Indian peninsula, it is dividing the large water body into two. One side it is, that is in the western side, Arabian Sea is there. You can see in the map, Arabian Sea, western side here. And in the eastern side there is Bay of Bengal is there. This tapering shape, that causes two branches of or two division of southwest monsoon wind. So that first division we can see, that is the Arabian Sea branch. As I told you, Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon wind, strikes the western coast of India. Western coast of India, especially in Kerala. It gives very heavy rainfall along the windward side of Western Ghats. And these winds are unable to cross over Western Ghats. Earlier also I have explained the same. Western Ghat in the Malabar region, Malabar coast itself, Western Ghat prevents. And windward side and leeward side we studied last year. Just remember. That is, where the rainfall is getting, side of the mountain, where the rainfall is getting, that side is called windward side. And the opposite side, where less rainfall or no rainfall at all, that side of the mountain is called leeward side. Here, southwest monsoon wind, it is moving towards the western side of the Western Ghat. That is why western side of the Western Ghat is called the windward side of the mountain. And the other side, Western Ghat's eastern side, is known as the leeward side of the southwest monsoon wind, so that there is less rainfall only. Due to that only, a part of Deccan region, there it is remains with the less rainfall. And also Deccan Plateau lying in the rain shadow of Western Ghats. We can say that rain shadow area, leeward side of the mountain is called rain shadow also. Rain shadow means less rainfall or no rainfall also. And for example, if we are continuing this one, in one of the important tourist spot in Maharashtra, that is called Mahabaleshwar, a tourist place in Maharashtra, on the western side of the Western Ghat receives almost 250 centimeter of rainfall. But whereas Pune, nearby Mahabaleshwar only, there is only a few kilometers away from Mahabaleshwar, Pune, there receives 70 centimeter rainfall only. As it remains in the both side. Mahabaleshwar is in the windward side of the Western Ghat, but Pune remains in the leeward side of the Western Ghat. Dear students, always there is a question it is asking related with this. Why there is less rainfall in Pune as compared to Mangalore or Mahabaleshwar? You can write the same answer related with the windward side and the leeward side of the mountain. And duration and amount of rainfall goes decreasing as Arabian Sea branch moves northward. Whenever it is moving towards the northern part of the country, its duration and amount of rainfall also decreasing. And it is taking place about 4 to 6 weeks to travel from Kanyakumari to Shivalik region. Within 4 to 6 weeks, it is reaching to Kanyakumari to Shivalik region, Purvanchal region. We have been studied from June 1st to July 15th, how it is spreading throughout the India. So Arabian branch, whenever it is moving, its intensity or the amount of rainfall, it is decreasing. Then also the presence of the Purvanchal mountain ranges or the Himalayan mountain ranges in the northeastern part, the mountain not allows to cross the southwest monsoon towards the other part of Asia. That is why it is existing almost 3 to 4 months, June to September in our country. Now let's see the other features of southwest monsoon winds, Arabian branch. As we have studied that there in central part of India there are two important other mountains are also there. One it is Vindhya Satpura mountain ranges. Vindhya Satpura mountain ranges parallel to Narmada river. After that there is nearby Rajasthan Thar desert, there is Aravalli mountain ranges are there. Aravalli mountain ranges. This Aravalli mountain ranges, it is parallel to the rain bearing southwest monsoon wind. That means parallel means direction of the southwest monsoon wind, it is not crossing or not obstructing this wind as it is parallel. The direction of the wind and the existence of the mountain, it is almost in the same direction. That is why there is no obstruction. Aravalli mountains alignment is parallel to the rain bearing southwest monsoon wind. As such, they do not offer any obstruction. Any hindrance, it is not taking place. That is why the southwest monsoon wind is not prevented by the Aravalli mountain ranges. That is why in this region, the western part of Rajasthan and the Thar desert area is not getting rainfall. Or very less rainfall only getting due to the southwest monsoon wind. One of the reasons why there is little rainfall in this region with the southwest monsoon wind. First goes Aravalli mountain ranges, it is parallel to the southwest monsoon wind and there is no obstruction to the southwest monsoon wind. But you know in Western Ghat it is preventing. Like that, how the Western Ghat is preventing, like that Aravalli mountain ranges are not preventing the southwest monsoon wind. Second reason, in this region there is less rainfall. In Rajasthan area, due to the desert region, the capacity of the air to hold moisture, that will be more. As this area is existing more temperature, the capacity to hold moisture, it is high. That means how much amount of water vapor it is adding to the air, that will not reach into the saturation point. Saturation point shows the RH, relative humidity. If the relative humidity 100%, then only there precipitation in the form of rainfall. See, in Rajasthan, whenever the moisture laden southwest monsoon wind passing, it do not saturate. As the heat in the desert region increases their capacity to hold moisture, so that the area will not saturate and will not get the rainfall. Dear students, it is very important this part. That is, two important reasons why Rajasthan, Western Rajasthan and Thar deserts not getting rainfall with the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon wind. These are the two reasons. First reason related with the alignment of Aravalli mountain ranges, which is parallel to the southwest monsoon wind. Second reason, it is the air does not saturate as the heat in the desert region increases their capacity to hold moisture. I think you understood these points. The next one, the total volume of the Arabian Sea branch is much more powerful than the Bay of Bengal branch. Two branches we have discussed, Arabian branch of southwest monsoon wind and Bay of Bengal branch. Comparison with the southwest monsoon wind, the volume of Arabian Sea branch is more than the Bay of Bengal branch. You know, reason is that at the right beginning itself, the western Ghat is deflecting the wind towards the northeastern part of India or the northern part of India. That is why. The Bay of Bengal branch is not having any obstruction. That is why it is moving towards the Bay of Bengal side, and almost in other part of our country, especially only in the Assam hills, it is touching. Of course, it is moving towards the Meghalaya, that we will see Meghalaya, and it is crossing our country, moving towards here. We can see the Myanmar country called Myanmar, our neighboring country. It is moving towards that and moving towards the southeastern part of Asia, as it creates no obstruction. So that comparison with both the branches of southwest monsoon wind, the volume of Arabian Sea branch is much more powerful, and it is more amount of rainfall it is getting in India due to the Arabian Sea branch. The whole of the Arabian Sea branch is used up by the entire country, whereas only the part of Bay of Bengal branch enters India through northeast India. And you can see that already we see that how it is enters Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon wind enters and moving towards whole part of our country, and how it is exhausting, how much days it is existing. Almost 3 to 4 months it is existing, and it is exhausted by the time it reaches Punjab and shed its moisture after the Bay of Bengal branch at the foothill of the Himalayas. Later, during the month of August, September, it is merging with the two branches of southwest monsoon wind. That is Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. It is merging together. Then the season changes. It is exhausted. Okay. Then we'll see in detail how the Bay of Bengal branch, it is influencing India's climate, or how it is getting rainfall in India. Bay of Bengal branch, that is in the eastern side of India. The Bay of Bengal branch reaching in Andaman Nicobar Island 1st June onwards, the beginning of the June onwards, it is reaching in Andaman Nicobar Island and Sri Lanka. Remember, as Arabian Sea branch, it is reaching in Kerala coast, Malabar coast. On the other hand, with the Bay of Bengal branch reaches into Andaman Nicobar Islands, here you can see, and it is moving towards Sri Lanka, touching in the Sri Lanka coast, receiving rainfall from the Bay of Bengal branch. Then it is advancing to moving towards northward, picking moisture after the Bay of Bengal, and it is moving towards northward. Here you have to remember that there is no obstruction in this area. That is why the wind move little fast. And its target, the Bay of Bengal branch target, is to move towards the northeastern mountain areas.
directly it is moving towards the northeastern mountain areas. Especially there we know that important hills of Assam hills, it is called like three Assam hills called Garo, Khasi and Jayantia hills are there. Assam hills they announced it is reaching to that area, Assam area it is reaching. And due to the influence of the Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon wind only, Muzamram near Chirapunji in Meghalaya, on the edge of Meghalaya, Chirapunji on the edge of Meghalaya, Meghalaya plateau stands at the end of the funnel shaped valley which acts as a trap for rain fearing Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon, and there is recorded as the highest rainfall in the world itself, heaviest rainfall in the world itself, that is average rainfall 1187.3 centimeter rainfall it is getting in this area due to the influence of Bay of Bengal branch, southwest monsoon winds, Bay of Bengal branch. In Muzamram, the rainfall it is getting, which is the highest recorded rainfall in the world, almost it is recorded that average rainfall, annual rainfall, it is 1187.3 centimeter rainfall it is getting due to the Bay of Bengal branch only. Students, question, it is a sure question. Here there is, that is the, what causes or which rain bearing wind causes rainfall in Meghalaya or in Chirapunji, Muzamram? Answer, that is the Arabian, the Bay of Bengal branch. And this Bay of Bengal branch wind deflecting towards west along the Himalayas, the presence of these mountains, Assam hills and the Purvanchal, it is deflecting the wind towards or redirecting the wind towards the northern states of India other than Jammu and Kashmir. The current finally merges with the Arabian Sea branch. Both the wind, Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch, it is merging together and shed remaining moisture at the foothills of the Himalayas. In the other areas of Himalayas, it is shedding. On its way, it gives rainfall to West Bengal region and Indo-Gigantic Plain area, this large area, Punjab to the West Bengal region, whole area it is getting rainfall, our state also, and Haryana and Punjab, throughout this area rainfall is getting. Almost September last week, both the branches, it is starting to moving back to the sea as the pressure condition and the temperature it is varies due to the apparent movement of the earth in relation to the sun. So these are the two branches of southwest monsoon wind. One it is Arabian Sea branch and the another one it is Bay of Bengal branch. Once again we can see the important points. The Arabian Sea branch, windward side of the western ghat, we have to remember here. windward side of the western ghat is well, the western ghat's the western side, and the rain shadow of western ghat is the eastern side of the western ghat where there is less rainfall or the rain shadow area. And little rainfall in Rajasthan, little rainfall, two reasons are there. The alignment of the Aravalli mountain ranges, it is parallel towards the direction of the southwest monsoon wind or the Arabian branch. Second reason, the capacity to hold moisture in this area, that is small, as the air occupies this area, it is dry, that is why the air is not reaching in the saturation point. These are the main points related with the Arabian Sea branch. And Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon wind, we can remember that the points like it strikes on Andaman, Nicobar and Sri Lanka, already studied. And later it is the direction, it is moving towards the northeastern hills like Assam hills. Three hills we studied, Assam hills mainly, Karo, Khasi and Jaintia. And also in Mizoram, Meghalaya plateau, away from Chirapunchi, there it is recorded as the highest rainfall. It is because of the movements of the Bay of Bengal branch. And later the wind deflects and get the rainfall with the help of the Bay of Bengal branch by the help of the southwest monsoon wind. These are the important points.